How is female pattern hair loss diagnosed?
Female pattern hair loss can be challenging to diagnose. The most common cause for hair loss in both men and women is genetic pattern hair loss, or androgenetic alopecia. However, hair loss in women can be associated with hormonal factors, such as polycystic ovarian syndrome, or PCOS, as well as menopause. Other causes of hair loss, such as alopecia areata, scarring conditions, and traction alopecia, are also often seen in women. I'll discuss how I diagnose and manage female pattern hair loss in my practice. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a diplomate of the American Board of Cosmetic Surgery and a fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I've been practicing in New York City and Long Island for over 25 years. I performed hair transplant surgery throughout my career. A major problem with hair transplant surgery is that a high percentage of hair grafts fail to grow after implantation. The range of lost hair grafts can be 30 to over 90%. In an effort to address this problem in 2011, I was using a wound healing material called extracellular matrix by ACell to help improve hair graft survival and donor area healing. This strategy appeared to work, as a year after surgery, there was improvement in graft survival and donor area healing. In addition, there was significant improvement in hair growth and hair density in the native hair where no transplant surgery was performed. This observation inspired me to pursue the development of a standalone, non-surgical treatment for male and female pattern hair loss, which we now call TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. We treat male and female pattern hair loss, as well as other hair loss conditions, with typically 1 to 2 treatment sessions about 18 months apart, and having sustained benefits lasting for 3 to 5 years or even longer. Although many years after I developed my system, PRP or PRP plus ACell is being offered by many medical retailers. Unsurprisingly, the treatments being conventionally offered require frequent injections and have inconsistent and limited results. So TrichoStem hair regeneration, from my perspective, remains the benchmark for hair regeneration treatment. Prior to TrichoStem hair regeneration, the treatment for female pattern hair loss was limited mostly to the topical application of minoxidil, as well as some anti-androgen drugs like spironolactone. In the course of seeing a wide range of female patients concerned about hair loss, it became clear that I had to develop a classification system for women experiencing hair loss that would allow me to customize treatment plans specific to a diagnosis or more than one diagnosis in the same individual. Further, I had to develop subclassifications and customize treatment plans accordingly. As far as women who come in for hair loss evaluation, two common diagnoses we see are female pattern hair loss and telogen effluvium. Female pattern hair loss is characterized by diffuse reduction in hair density and miniaturization or thinning of the individual strands of hair. Generally, the progression of female pattern hair loss occurs almost imperceptibly over years in an insidious way. Some women will have receding temples, but generally female pattern hair loss is a diffuse thinning process. It is oftentimes a widening of the hair part and is described in the medical literature as a Christmas tree pattern. In contrast, the condition called telogen effluvium is characterized by significant hair shedding, often preceded by a stressful event. This condition is usually self-limited and not characterized by long-term or permanent hair loss. Now, hormonal issues related to pregnancy and conditions such as polycystic ovarian syndrome or PCOS can affect hair growth. We also see a lot of women who have traction alopecia caused by the constant tension on their hair follicles from tight hairstyles such as ponytails and braids. In the African American population, we see patients who have a condition called central centrifugal cicatricial alopecia, or CCCA. This is a type of scarring alopecia characterized by central hair thinning, which expands and widens over time. As I mentioned earlier, you can have more than one of these diagnoses. If there's a question about a diagnosis, in addition to clinical examination, I will perform a scalp biopsy for microscopic evaluation. A decrease in estrogen production is generally considered a contributing factor in female pattern hair loss in postmenopausal women. So, estrogen supplementation may be considered in addition to other treatments to stimulate hair growth, such as TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. As I discussed earlier, we treat a lot of women with female pattern hair loss and have over 99% success in helping our female pattern hair loss patients see visible improvement in hair thickness and density, resulting in improvement in scalp coverage. One of the greatest challenges to helping women with hair loss is increasing awareness of treatment options. Many of my patients inform me that their hairdressers are delighted by seeing the results of TrichoStem hair regeneration with their own eyes, and they're excited to help their other clients learn more about options to treat female pattern hair loss. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.